scandal of Obama, a.k.a. Eric Holder, because he's there aiding and abetting, covering up, absconding, racketeering, suppressing, persecuting, going after political enemies, throwing the book at people that have done nothing, running his giant witch hunt operation while protecting the big mega banks looting the country, protecting an entire bipartisan takeover. What do you think's really going on? What do you think is really, really happening here? I want to hear from you. We know he's a criminal. We know he's escaped impeachment. We know he's escaped ignoring congressional subpoenas. He's been arrogant. He's been threatening. So it's important to pillory him as he rides off on a golden carpet to loot the taxpayers in the revolving door. But what is your view on Eric Holder? What is your view on what's happening with the stock market? 800-259-9231. Now, before I go to your phone calls, there is a product from InfoWarsLife.com developed by Dr. Group that you've got to go read about online. It's got all of these different concentrated flower and plant and root extracts. I mean, just a whole bunch of them. And you've got to understand that when you normally buy a similar product in claims, it'll just have some menthol and maybe one herb in it or something. And I'm not knocking Ricola, but let's say it's got three or four herbs in it compared to Luden's that has nothing. This has, I think it's like 14 different things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, 14 things. Okay, I was right. The point is, 13, 14, is that if you look at it in the bottle, there's no additives or fillers. It's just pure essential oil. And competing products are the same price, but it's just thin water because they're cheap. Because people will buy stuff just for the packaging. This really is a revolutionary product. And the reason I was thinking that I need to plug it more, so I did a lot of yelling when I gave a speech Saturday down at KC Research, and I could barely talk on Sunday. And about a third of the way into the show, I went, wait a minute. On Sunday, I said, why aren't I doing my lung cleanse that immediately coats my larynx? Or if I have really bad allergies or a sore throat, I mean, it's just light years better than any other throat-type spray lozenges. But also, the way Group says to do it, is you got to watch it. It's so thick it clogs the top deal, so you got to blow it out sometimes after you've been using it 6 or 7 times, or you put it in hot water, the little cap, because you want it. This has a really nice spray top on it that aerosolizes it. 3 shots in the mouth. And on the third one, you don't spray and then inhale. That would be too much. You spray 3 times and then go, and then some of the effervescence, some of the mist goes into the lungs, and it's just amazing. And then it funds our whole operation. The subscriptions to PrisonPlanet.tv, the pro-gun t-shirts, the high-quality InfoWars Life products, funds the operation. So I want to thank you all for your support and just encourage all of you that have gotten the other InfoWars Life line of products out there to check out Lung Cleanse that I really haven't talked up enough. It sells quite well. It's just that I haven't really talked it up enough, and I think it is. I know this Group, when he was developing it for us, was so excited about it because it is an over-the-top product that if you look at it, is thick. I mean, it's very thick, and it tastes really good, very minty but also very earthy. I don't know how to describe it, but so many other similar things on the surface just have weird taste or just has stuff in there to make your throat numb. This doesn't have any of that. This soothes your throat without any of that artificial garbage. InfoWarsLife.com, Lung Cleanse. So proud of it. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 888-253-3139. And take the InfoWarsLife.com challenge. Go get the Oxy tablets that flush out the guts. Get the Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, the Silver Bullet, the X2 Pure Crystal Source True Nascent Iodine at InfoWarsLife.com. Oh, and look what else is up there, DNA Force. So that's all available at InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139, Lung Cleanse. Okay. After we take calls, here's some of the other news we have from Kit Daniels from InfoWars. United Nations to propose global lead ammo ban. That's from the UN. Proposal would serve as a backdoor gun control by cutting global supply of ammo. Just like I said 2 weeks ago, where they're passing laws to basically ban lead ammo in California, making ammo prices go up 300%, it's estimated, the next year, maybe more. In fact, that was a low estimate by the group that broke it all down in a study. That this is UNESCO. This is UN treaties unimplemented, but California and New York and others and cities, they call it UN municipalization under Agenda 21. Cities are adopting it. Austin, where my mother grew up, I believe the best city in Texas, bar none, for a big town. For a big city, it's great. There's a lot of other small towns that are much better. Austin used to be a small town, 40,000 people when my mom grew up here. Now it's 2 million, but be 4 million, they're saying, another 10 years. It's just exploding. But it's officially under UN control. They don't follow the Constitution, Bill of Rights. And there's some old-line liberals here, so there's some nice things about old-line liberals, about it's not too police statey and some other things, but it's got that modern UN thing to it that's seen as trendy and sexy. It's actually a nightmare. So that's coming up. FBI says no one killed at Sandy Hook. Agency publishes crime report showing zero murders occurred in Newtown in 2012. And people can say, well, that must be an FBI crime statistic mistake. And that does happen sometimes. I'm a big critic of a lot of what the FBI does, but their statistics have been known over the years to be the best in the world. Started by J. Edgar Hoover. That's what he was a statistician and basically a filing clerk who was a master at organizational skills. And it's the model worldwide in colleges for statistics because it's gathered locally and then compiled. Remember the FBI didn't put Osama bin Laden on the most wanted list for 9/11? I guess because they didn't want a bounty out there for him or something. 4 years, four years after we were making a big deal about it and there'd been national news stories about it, they still wouldn't put him on the most wanted list. So is this some kind of inside joke or something? We're going to talk to Wolfgang Halbig about that coming up. Cop asks man for license, shoots him when he goes to get it, WLTX. The guy's at a gas station, gassing his car up. If you're a TV viewer, you can see this at InfoWars.com/show. If you're a radio listener, go to InfoWars.com. We have the video from WLTX out of South Carolina, Columbia, South Carolina up there. And talk about instinctive shooting. I mean, this is scary. The guy's gassing his car up, and we're showing the video now, and he says, give me your license. So the guy turns around to get it, and he does do it a little quickly, almost like a kid when you're saying, put your shoes on, and they kind of stomp on you. Sit down real fast, but the guy kind of turns quick, but that doesn't give you license to kill him. And the cop starts shooting him. And then he runs over to him, and the cop's such a bad shot, he didn't hit him center of mass. And the guy's like, man, it's my license, it's right here. And the cop is still like jumping on top of him after that. It's just go join special forces, and then you can actually go fight people that want to kill you, and then you can treat them all like that. But just, it's like an attack dog, like you open a door and a pit bull that's been eating gunpowder comes running out, you know, just savage, vicious, crazed. And then I read deeper into it. The guy wasn't even a suspect. I mean, one thing if it was a vehicle that matched your description of an armed robber who's thought to be dangerous and served 10 years for shooting somebody, then if the guy made a move and something, and I'd still say it was, you know, the cop's too on edge and should not be a cop. But the fact that this guy hadn't even done anything, and the police are so militarized, this is how they approach you, is frightening, ladies and gentlemen. Because I personally